Hello, I'm Tiffany from Cal State Dominguez-Sales Athletics Department, and welcome to the Toros Coaches Corner. For this segment, I'd like to welcome a very special guest, the man in charge of the department, none other than Cal State Dominguez-Sales Director of Athletics, Patrick Guillen. Well, hello, Patrick. Welcome to Toros Coaches Corner. DH had a great season athletically in 2009 and 2010, with the women's soccer team finishing as the NCAA runners-up, six teams making the NCAA postseason, and a record 16 All-American awards. What can we expect in 2010 and 11?
Well, I think from what you've already heard from some of the coaches that preceded me is I think we return a great nucleus of talent that will compete on their respective venues of competition for conference championships and also for NCAA postseason berths again. That's a given. They're bringing in new talent that will only help that even more. We, for the most part, had very, very young teams last year, and so I'm excited about that. But other things that you will expect is you'll expect us to continue to see hard work not only out of the classroom, but even more importantly in the classroom. The community has come to expect to see our active involvement not only on the campus community, but also in the community in general here in the South Bay.
Now, this is your sixth year as the Toros Athletics Director. What change are you most proud of since you began?
I don't think I can pinpoint it to one, to be honest with you. I think, first of all, I'd have to say that none of it could have happened without, you know, a great staff and a great coaching staff as well, and also the support of our senior administration here on campus. But to highlight a few things that I am really important is the core areas of our department, which I think is our basic philosophy, and that is academics, number one, athletics, and community service. And you've seen in academics, you've seen our team GPAs rise substantially. This last year, we were at 2.91, which is pretty impressive with 220-plus student-athletes. You've seen a rise in our retention rates and our graduation rates, so that's something that I'm extremely proud of. You've seen us be successful on the fields. Very impressed with that. Our men's soccer team won a national championship 2 years ago. Our women's soccer team made it to the national championship game last year. We've had numerous All-Americans, academic All-Americans, athletic All-Americans. And I'm very extremely proud of our student-athlete advisory committee, who runs a lot of community service events with Read Across America and what we do with the Make-A-Wish Foundation. There's many, many things that we do through our SAC, and that is something that I'm very, very proud of. When I became the athletic director 5 years ago, one of the prevailing concerns from the student athletes was our lack of a suitable training room, mm-hmm. or weight room, as the campus calls it. And that is something 5 years ago, 4.5 years ago, that we were able to renovate and put a lot of money into it. And now it's not only suitable, but it's state-of-the-art. We have state-of-the-art equipment in there, which is very, very important to their well-being and to their training and strength and conditioning. So those are just some of the highlights. I mean, there's a lot of things, and I could probably spend the next hour and talk about that. But I think mostly our academics, our graduation rates, and how involved we are in the community is something that I'm most proud of.
Now, we know that all the teams are important to you. But as a former athlete and someone who's so involved with the teams, which season sport do you most look forward to watching as a fan?
Well, that's kind of a loaded question, don't you think, Tiffany? But, you know, I'll always have a soft part in my heart for baseball. I played baseball for 18 years. And so that's something that I really look forward to. That's a sport that I really look forward to. But to be perfectly honest, I enjoy watching all of our programs. It just amazes me that how our student athletes can compete at the level that they do, knowing everything else that they have to, the requirements that they have outside of the playing field, just to be successful. Carrying a full load academically, maintaining their GPA, study hall, practice time, traveling time, almost, I'd say about 65% of our student athletes have part-time jobs. Some of them even have full-time jobs. Some of them are single parents. And so to see the outside stressors that they have on top of what they do on their respective venues and competitions is pretty impressive. So I enjoy all of it, all of the sports.
Go ahead and talk about the administration and how vital they've been to the department.
Well, I think it's pretty obvious for somebody to look in, especially with President Garcia and my boss, Dr. Sue Borrego, the incredible support that they've given athletics since they've been here. Now, I think Dr. Garcia has been here a little over 3 years. I think this is going on her fourth year. And, she's got an amazingly busy schedule, but she still takes time out of her schedule to come to the games and, drop emails to the coaches. She has been very, very supportive and something that I haven't seen in my 15 years I've been on this campus. And then, of course, Dr. Borrego is just amazing. She is a great sports fan. She loves to come out to almost every game. She interacts with our coaches on a regular basis and our student athletes, and there's a real direct connect there. And that's the support that we need to be successful here at Cal State Dominguez Hills. And to be perfectly honest, I talk to my colleagues all across the country, and every athletic department needs the full support of the senior administration on campus in order for them to be successful. And we certainly have that here at Cal State Dominguez Hills.
Well, Patrick, we thank you for the work that you do for this department to keep it running every day. And we thank you for joining us on this edition of the Toros Coaches Corner. And until we see you in the stands, remember to make every day your masterpiece. Go Toros.
Go Toros.